As I said in my previous videos, the typical way Telegram invites people to design their bots is by creating these kind of commands that have that start with the forward slash, and then they have a word that defines what is the action that you want to ask the bot to do, and then followed by whatever information you need. Okay. So we're going to implement a few of those custom commands. And the way we're going to do this is by using the idiom or the pattern that the application, that the library that we're using, the Node Telegram Bot API, invites us to do. You can see here that just as I defined what I wanted to do whenever the robot, whenever the bot received a message, so on receiving this message, please do this stuff. Whenever you receive any message, please do all this stuff here. Similarly, this API has another event handler called onText, which is specifically if the incoming data is text. And now here, when we define what is going to come, instead of defining a string called message, as in whatever you give me, just work with that, what we have to define is a regular expression. Regular expressions are a way of defining a pattern that you're looking for when you want to analyze a string, and then also a way to define some information that you want to extract when you are also analyzing a string. Full disclaimer, regular expressions can be a little tricky to start with because the syntax of how they are defined can be a little convoluted, but they're actually very, very powerful. And one tool that I can recommend for regular expressions is this one here, regex101.com. This one is really, really good for testing, and it has all this helper text here that allows you to figure out how to create regular expressions and what each part of the regular expression means, etc., and to test them out here, and with different flavors of regular expressions. It's really, really good. I strongly recommend it. So the way we're going to do that is any regular expression is written between two forward slashes, okay? And then I'm going to get back to that. And then, for example, let's say that we wanted to match exactly the word echo, for example. So what we would do is we would write echo here, and then in between the two forward slashes. This is specific to JavaScript, okay? And I will get to improving this a little better before. And then here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to write the function, the callback function, that we need to write, and that is going to be executed whenever this event is triggered. Now, I also know that this function, because of the helper text and because of the documentation that I've read, this callback function is given two arguments. One is going to be given the full message that has been received by the bot, and also the second one is going to be the matching for the regular expression. I will explain what that means in a second. So for the time being, I'm just going to write here the names of the two inputs that we're going to be taking, okay? And then to see if this works, I'm just going to write here received an echo request, for example, all right? And I'm going to deactivate this response to any general message for the time being so that we don't get confused. Wonderful. So I'm going to stop my server that was running in the background. I'm going to restart it again, okay? And then you can see that now my bot should not respond to any message whatsoever. So for example, if I type here, blah, 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 it's not really doing anything. But however, if I write echo, you can see that it picked up with this regular expression, the exact match of the word echo, and therefore printed something here to the console. We could, like I did before, we could say, we could create a response, received a request for echo, for example. And then we could respond to the user bot, send message, message.chat.id, and then this response message that I just created. If I restart my server now, you can see that I can now write echo, and the bot is going to respond, yes, I know, I received a request for echo. Okay? But we need to improve this a little bit. First of all, what I would like to do is I would like to type echo like this so that I stick to the conventions of Telegram bots and the forward slash. So that's one thing. And the other thing is that I would like for the bot to echo whatever is after the echo. So for example, if I type hello world, what I would like to for the bot is to respond to me back, hey, I want you to respond to me hello world. Okay? So let's do that then. So the way we're going to do that is, first of all, I need to add the forward slash. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to tap another forward slash, but that doesn't work because forward slashes are a very special character in strings. So we need to actually escape that forward slash by using a backslash. Yes. Don't get me started on this. I'm not sure who designed this, but yes. So basically, backslashes are a special character to denote that the next character should be treated specially. And therefore, the way you specified in a string that you do want a forward slash and not to be confused with the ones that are used in regular expressions is by escaping it with a backslash. So that's one thing. The other thing is that I want to be able to read whatever is coming after the forward slash echo part. The way we do that typically is by what's called matching a string with the regular expression. The regular expressions are good for detecting when things match similarly, but they're also really good at picking up particular parts of a string that also match a different pattern. So in this particular case, what I want is, I want the regular expression to detect if at the beginning of the sentence, there is a forward slash with an echo. And if that's true, then I want to fetch out everything that is coming after the white space of that echo. The way I can do that is by typing here, as you can see in the example, typing a matching pattern, a matching group, which we do with an open and a closed parenthesis that denotes that that's a matching group. And what I'm doing, and inside, I want to write the pattern that defines what do I want to pick up. And because I basically want to pick up anything that is after the forward slash echo, what I do is I type dot, which is the character in regular expression that denotes just give, take everything, all right? And I'm going to write plus, which is the character that we use to modify the dot, which means don't pick up just one character of any kind. Pick up as many characters as you can of any kind. This is something that we could also read here from the, oops, sorry, I'm right on top of it, that we could read something here from the expression. So for example, you can see here that the dot, you cannot see it because my head is right on the way. You can see here that the dot, god damn it, you can see here that the dot is any single character, and you see the dot here, all right? And then if I find the modifiers, what are the modifiers? Yes, one of more of A. So if you add the plus symbol, you get one or more of whatever you added that plus symbol to. So long story short, if we type dot plus, you're basically saying, I want to pick every single character of any kind. It doesn't have to be constrained to letters or numbers. And I want to fetch with the plus sign as many of those as possible. So if I do that, then what's interesting is that the matching variable in the callback is going to contain all the matching strings that are going to come back from the regular expression, the evaluation of the regular expression. So for example, just to take a good look at what that looks like, let me print out to the console the full matching object so that we can see how that looks. So I'm going to stop the server, Control C. I'm going to clear up the screen. I'm going to restart it with the new changes that I did. And I'm going to type the same thing. Echo, and for example, regular expression test. As I do that, you can see that the match, so what the evaluation of the regular expression gives me, is an array with a lot of stuff. The first element being the full message of the regular expression, and the second element being the matching group that I have created. So that basically that tailing part right after the echo, so the result of this matching pattern here. Which means that if I just want to read that, what I need to do is I need to take the second element of that array. Okay? So, for example, what can we do? I can create another variable which is going to be called in the data, for example, the data that is coming with the echo instruction, and I can say this has to be equal to the second element of the array in the match object. And then what I can do is, instead of responding with this thing, what I can do is I can respond exactly with that information, with the what was given as part of the echo. So let me restart this. Let me restart the bot again. And now finally, I think this is now going to work. Echo. And then I'm going to say, hello world. And then the bot is responding exactly with hello world. Echo parametric camp rules. And then yoo-hoo, parametric camp rules. Echo, this is fun. And then the bot responds exactly with that same message. This is fun. All right. Wonderful. So it looks like we were able now to create an echo command, so that the robot can now respond to an echo command and then just respond exactly with that same message. Let's take a look at another very simple example of another command that we could implement. Okay, so for example, let's create now a greet command, so that whenever we pass a name, the bot responds with, hey, name, how are you doing? Blah, 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 something like that. Also a very simple string manipulation exercise. So for example, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create bot on whenever I receive text, and then whenever that text starts with the word greet, so I'm going to create my regular expression, I'm going to escape a forward slash, and then I'm going to write here greet, and then I'm going to add the matching pattern to capture any single characters that come afterwards. And then now I'm going to write my callback, which is going to be message, which is going to be given two arguments, message and the matching pattern. And then what I'm going to do now is that I'm going to create a response, which is going to be, for example, hello, and then the name of that has been passed to, which is, remember, the second element of the matching pattern. Hello, match. How are you doing? How are you doing? And then we're going to send that back to the user. Message.chat.id. And then the response that we just created. So let's see if this works. So I'm going to stop the server. I'm going to run it again. And then I'm going to say, greet Jose Luis. And then, hello, Jose Luis, how are you doing? Greet Salvador. Oops, sorry for the typo. Greet Gabby. How are you doing? You see? And now the bot is able to respond dynamically. We could also implement like two or three different sentences. For example, hi, what's up? Or hello, how are you doing? Or yo, 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 whatever, you know? And then randomly choose between them whenever we respond to this greeting message. Also, don't forget that we have both behaviors attached, which means that I still have the echo behavior. So I can still boo You know, I can and I can still use the greeting functionality. So we can add as many of these as we want, and they're not conflicting with each other, right? Even though right now, if the robot doesn't understand whatever I say, then it's just not going to respond to any of this. All right. Okay. This is great. I think this is a good start for creating a the backend service that that makes a bot work. However, the problem with this is that right now what we're doing is we are creating that service, the service that runs the logic, so the backend of the bot, is a program that is living on my machine, on my local machine right now. Which means that if I stop that program on my machine, or if I turn off my computer or whatever, then the robot is basically the robot is basically done. Are you there? You see, I asked for that echo, but then the bot is not responsive. It's not responsive because I turn off the backend service that runs this bot. What that means is that this technique that we have used right now is great for testing. So the idea of having a local backend service, but if you want this bot to live forever, to live online and for a lot of users to be able to use it, then hosting it on your local machine could be a possibility, but you would have to have that machine always running and connected to the server. You could put it in a Raspberry Pi, which is a very cheap and very simple thing. And for example, that could be a one way to go, or you can just put this service, the backend, and make it live somewhere on the cloud, like for example, glitch.com, which is the service that we saw before in previous videos. So in the next video, what I'm going to teach you is how to take this backend service and move it to the cloud so that it is permanent, or that it's living forever, and then everyone can use it and everyone can interact with your robot at any time of the day without you having to have this local machine running. So let's take a look at how that works.